Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kathleen Gagne, and I am very pleased to welcome you to Mechanics Hall. I direct the marketing and outreach, which luckily includes the free Worcester Organ Concert Series. Today's concert is a very special addition to that series as we continue our year-long celebration of the 150th anniversary of our glorious E and G.G. Hook Brothers Organ, also known as the Worcester Organ. The Worcester chapter of the American Guild of Organists collaborates with Mechanics Hall in producing the concert series with artistic direction from Will Sherwood. Thank you, Will. He's supposed to be in his usual spot. Thank you, Will, for all you do to promote Mechanics Hall and our beautiful organ. I'm going to recite a litany of today's performers because there are so many wonderful people who have come together today to make this so special. Peter Edwin Krasinski, Dorothy Van Andel Frisch, Kevin Murphy, Robin Dinda, Lucia Clemente Falco, Scott Michael Olson, Malcolm Halliday, Choir Director Matthew Johnson, choristers from First Congregational Church of Shrewsbury, First Parish Church of Berlin, and the Master Singers of Worcester, the Parish Peelers and Shrewsbury Ringers, bell choirs from the First Congregational Church of Shrewsbury, conducted by Angie Esterbrook, cellist Betsy Bronstein, flutist Samantha McGill, and pianist Eric Wiefald. All of the organists today are hook organ veterans. They understand the nuances and the complexities demanded by our 3,504 pipe tracker organ. Performers in the program's first half are Peter Edwin Krasinski, Dorothy Van Andel Frisch, Kevin Murphy, and Robin Dinda. After the first part of the program, we'll break for a brief intermission, and just before the second half, we'll pass a basket for a free will offering. Mechanics Hall accepts your gifts with heartfelt thanks and designates today's donations for the organ refurbishment project, which will continue this summer. Welcome to the stage, Peter Krasinski.
Hi, everybody.
As Dean of the Worcester Chapter of the American Guild of Organists, it's my honor and delight to offer the sealed envelope with the theme for today's improvisation, symphonic improvisation,
three movements. Oh, Ode to Joy. Okay, good choice. Heard that before. So there'll be three movements. It's a symphonetta, so it's not going to be 3 hours long, don't worry. So enjoy. Thank you.
among the great players today, I wanted to make sure that Steve Wade was mentioned. He's my cousin. We've been playing since we were very small. He recently retired from the Coast Guard Band in New London, Connecticut, after playing for 30 years for the Guard, and presently is one of the oboists for the Hartford Symphony. And I thank him a great deal for playing today. This is my daughter, Cecilia, who's going to turn my pages.
Kaya Pup Strut is one in a series of compositions that I've written that feature our pets. So there is Max Cat Rag, Charlie Dog Blues, Kiara Pig Jig. Kaya is currently our Brittany. She still lives with us. If you'd like to see her, I made a YouTube performance of this piece, and Miss Kaya plays a cameo towards the end. Give me just a moment to set up. The pace of life was a lot slower in 1864.
as organists, we do appreciate your support with whatever the collection, for the collection, because of the expenses that are always ever present with an instrument like this. I have a few notes in the program, but just to reiterate a little bit, the piece I'm going to play is actually from a recital that I played here several years ago. The recital was scheduled for December 3rd, 2003. It was a brown bag concert. And I had planned the program around some standard organ literature, as well as a couple of transcriptions. And then I was trying to think of something to end the program with, which would be more something unusual and different. So I went about trying to find out if there was something special about December 3rd that I could use as a theme. And I found out that it was Walt Disney's birthday. So I set about creating something using what I call classic Disney tunes. And I say that because these tunes come from movies that are considered from a long time ago now at this point. And you'll hear the introduction, which is from, I think it was a TV show that's now really ancient history, the Mickey Mouse Club. So, and the tunes I chose are some of my favorites. They're really nice tunes. I don't know much about the modern the movies of Disney, but these are the ones that stood out in my mind. So. Sorry, just wanted to add that I could not find a sketch or a note about the music at all from that recital. And so what I had to do was listen to the CD of the concert, which Joe Celorio had made that day. And so for this recital, for this performance, I'm just playing what it was from the CD of that concert.
Well, hello everyone and welcome to Historic Mechanics Hall. It's great to be here. I'm Scott Michael Olson, and as just a word of fleshing out what I put in the program, I'm told that when I was 4 years old, I came home from my aunt's wedding and played the wedding march on the piano. And that was the first time people knew that I had any musical ability at all. I'm also told that I'm a little emotionless in life, but when I play, my emotions come out, and I'm hoping to express that here today. As a word of just explanation, I'll be at the organ for my first piece, I'll go to the piano for my second piece, and I'll conclude with an organ piece. Thank you.
Thank you, folks. While everyone's getting on stage, I just wanted to tell you a little bit about the next piece that you're going to hear, which is in two parts. The festival postlude, as I explained in the program notes, I wrote this past fall for the double installation, the installation of the two pastors at our church. One is Reverend Eric Wefald, who is presiding at the piano, and also Reverend Lynn Nolan. And the interesting thing about it was that the piece worked just fine as kind of a short festive postlude. I remember Lynn in particular told me, she said, what do you want for the music at your installation service? She said, well, I would really love something with drums. So I thought, okay, we'll write something for organ and drums, and that will kind of make everybody happy and maybe contribute something, because there's not many pieces out there for organ and drums. So that's fun. So it was a short little piece. And I thought, when I found out about this composer's event, I thought, well, gee, it really needs a companion piece. It needs something to make it just a little bit longer and give it a little bit more gravitas, if you will. And so I thought, okay, well, that'll be fine and dandy. I'll write a meditation. The only problem was it's been a very busy spring, and I never had time to write it. So literally, I started it about 2 weeks ago, and I handed the bell ringers here the music this past Wednesday night. Turns out it was a little bit too complicated to learn this quickly. So we went to plan B. I created another bell part. We tried it out this morning, and everything seemed to go fine. So wish us luck. Thank you. Sorry, I was preoccupied. I didn't stand up to acknowledge that. I wanted to thank all my bell ringers for lugging everything down to the hall. That was really great. Thank you so much, folks. Now, I wanted to say something about the next piece, which is, and this is in the program notes, but we may have run out of the long version of the program. This piece was commissioned some time ago, and it was in honor of 50 years as choir director and serving the music ministry of the First Parish Church of Berlin. And this was in honor of Barbara Crackhart. And she is here in the audience, and I'd like for her please to stand. Not many of us have the opportunity to serve a church for 50 years in one capacity like that. It's just amazing. And I'm so glad that so many people from the First Parish Church of Berlin could be here to sing in our combined choir today. Now, the only other thing I want to mention is if you don't have a long version of the program, try to sit near someone that does and ask if you can share with them. This work does require some audience participation, and you're not going to get out of here without getting a chance to sing with us. And we hope that you will, and you will lend your voice, because we're going to crank up the organ. And the text, a wonderful text by Worcester native Thomas Rossiello, is celebrating music. So I think we can all get into that. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us today for this absolutely beautiful concert. I'd like to mention a couple more people who I failed to mention earlier today. That was Stan Hansen of the AGO, who helped to coordinate today's concert. And of course, our organ master, Stefan Meyer. He's not here today. He's taking a few well-deserved days off. Stefan Meyer has been working on the organ consistently for the last year and will be also doing so throughout the summer. So we're very grateful to him that we are celebrating the 150th of this instrument. On behalf of Mechanics Hall and the Worcester Chapter, American Guild of Organists, I'd like to thank you again for attending today's concert. Will our organists all come up and join me on the stage, please, for one last bow? I'd also like you all to know that every single performer here today donated their many hours of time and talent to make this extraordinary event available for all of us. They also have the Great Organs of Worcester CD on sale in the back. And if you have any questions about Mechanics Hall or the Worcester Chapter of AGO, we'll all be happy to help you with that. So thanks, everyone. Thanks to Will Sherwood, our artistic director. Also, the next time we celebrate the 150th will be August 6th. It's a free noontime concert. We're featuring a young organist, as we do every summer. So August 6th, next time, noontime, free of charge. Thanks so much for coming today.